पंचायत राज, अ थ्री टायर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द इंडियन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन फॉर रूरल डेवलपमेंट इज कॉल्ड पंचायत राज। द एम ऑफ पंचायत राज इज टू डेवलप लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट्स इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स, जोन्स एंड विलेजेस। दिस वीडियो विल प्रोवाइड यू विद इवोल्यूशन, वेरियस कमिटीज सेटअप फॉर पंचायत राज, साइलेंट फीचर्स ऑफ 73rd एंड 74th कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अमेंडमेंट एक्ट एंड द अदर डिटेल्स रिगार्डिंग। Constitution. Panchayat Raj is included in the Constitution with two main objectives. First one, that is decentralization of power and development of villages. That means rural development is one of the main objective of Panchayat Raj, and this has been established in all states of India except Nagaland, Meghalaya and Mizoram. In all union territories except Delhi and certain other areas, these areas include the scheduled areas and the tribal areas in the states, the hill areas of Manipur for which a district council exists, and Darjeeling districts of West Bengal for which Darjeeling Gorakh Hill Council exists. There were a number of committees appointed by the Government of India to study the implementation of self-government at the rural level and also recommend steps in the achieving this goal. The first committee appointed as a Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. The committee was appointed in 1957 to examine and suggest measures for better working of the community development program and the National Extension Service. The committee suggested the establishment of democratic decentralized local government, which came to be known as the Panchayat Raj. Some recommendation by the committee, that means first one, that is three-tier Panchayat Raj system, Gram Panchayat, Panchayat Samiti and Jilla Parishad. Directly elected representatives to constitute the Gram Panchayat and indirectly elected representatives to constitute the Panchayat Samiti and Jilla Parishad. Planning and development are the primary objectives of the Panchayat Raj system. Panchayat Samiti should be the executive body and Jilla Parishad will act as the advisory and supervisory body. District collector to be made as the chairman of the Jilla Parishad. It also requested to provisioning resources so as to help them discharge their duties and responsibilities. The second committee is Ashok Mehta Committee. The committee was appointed in 1977 to suggest measures to review and strengthen the declining Panchayat Raj system in India. Some of the key recommendations are, the three-tier system should be replaced with two-tier, that is Jilla Parishad, district level, and the Mandal Panchayat, a group of villages. District level as the first level of supervision after the state level. Jilla Parishad should be the executive body and responsible for planning at the district level. The institution, that is Jilla Parishad and Mandal Panchayat, to have compulsory taxation powers to mobilize their own financial resources. So the implication of Panchayat Raj or municipalities as the third tier of governance on India's federal structure. Panchayat Raj includes village panchayat, block or taluka panchayat and jilla panchayat, while municipality includes nagar panchayat, municipal council and municipal corporation. Now you see the salient features of the 73rd and 74th Constitutional Amendment Act. Panchayat and municipalities will be the institution of self-government. Basic units of democratic system, Gram Sabha at village level and ward committees at municipalities comprising all the adult members registered as voters. Three-tier system of panchayat at village intermediate block, taluka, mandal and district levels. Smaller states with population below 2 million only two tiers. Seats at all levels filled by direct election. Seats reserved for scheduled caste, SCs and chairperson of the panchayat at all levels also shall be reserved for SCs and STs in proportion to their population. 1/3 of the total number of seats reserved for women, 1/3 seats reserved for SCs and STs also reserved for women. 1/3 offices of chairperson at all level reserved for women. Uniform 5-year term and election to constitute new bodies to be completed before the expiry of the term. In the event of dissolution, election compulsory within 6 months. Independent Election Commission in each state for superintendence, direction and control of the electoral rolls. Panchayats to prepare plans for economic development and social justice. In respect of 29 subjects listed in 11th schedule, 74th amendment provides for a district planning committee to consolidate the plan prepared for panchayat and municipalities. Funds. Budgetary allocation from state governments, revenue of certain taxes, collect and retain the revenue it raises, central government programs and grants. In each state, a finance commission to determine the principle on the basis of which adequate financial resource will be ensured for panchayats and municipalities. So this is all about Panchayat Raj system. There are some questions related to Panchayat Raj system. For example, who is the father of Panchayat Raj? The answer is Balwant Raj Mehta was the father of Panchayat Raj. Balwant Raj Mehta was a parliamentary who is credited for pioneering the concept of the Panchayat Raj in India, and also it is known as the father of Panchayat Raj. The second question is, what is the importance of Panchayat Raj? The answer is, Panchayat Raj institutes village local government that plays a significant role in the development of village, especially primary education, health, agricultural developments, women and child developments, and women participation in local government, etc. The next question, that is, which state in India has no Panchayat Raj institution? All states of India has Panchayat Raj systems except Nagaland, Meghalaya and Mizoram in all union territories except Delhi and certain other areas. These are the questions related to Panchayat Raj. Thank you.